Children, in the previous video, we learned more about the area of square and rectangle through some interesting examples. In this video, we will see some of the misconceptions related to this. Babban is preparing to bake a cake for Banno's birthday. Just then, Appu came to his house.
What are you doing, Babban?
I am preparing to bake a cake for Banno.
Oh wow, Babban. But why did you use this small tray instead of this big tray to bake the cake?
Appu, I have found the perimeter of both trays in this way. And look, the perimeters of both are exactly the same. 36 centimeters. This means that both trays are exactly the same.
Babban, it is not necessary that the areas of two rectangles having equal perimeters would also be the same. So, it is not necessary that because the perimeters of these two trays are the same, their areas will also be the same. Look, the area of this rectangle shaped tray will be 12 times 6 or 72 square centimeters. And the area of this rectangle shaped tray will be 10 times 8 or 80 square centimeters. So, this tray is bigger than this tray. Understood?
I understood. Now, I will make Banno's birthday cake in this big tray. You must come to her birthday party, Appu.
Babban baked a beautiful cake for Banno using that big tray. Children, in this video, we saw some misconceptions related to the area of square and rectangle.